There's a small comment that احنا كنا بنحط هون 100 جنيه عشان بننفع
كل العضلات. يدينا very nice view, بس there is a risk هنا بتاع ال anterior tibial artery, وده اللي هنتكلم عليه مع ال posterolateral approach دلوقتي. فاحنا now we're going to, احنا we've talked yesterday about the posterolateral. If you have this fragment on the back, you can either reach a little bit with extended anterolateral as we saw before the coffee break, أو through a fibular osteotomy, أو another approach around which you don't use much, أو ال direct posterolateral اللي احنا هنعمله دلوقتي, direct posterolateral approach. So these are the three areas how you can reach the same fragment. But this is what we want to do. We want to put a small mini plate on the posterolateral. ما ياخدش اكتر من كده. This is a limited approach. هو كبير شوية لكن هو actually بيديك limited access عشان ال anterior tibial artery. This is our main risk from this approach. Well, this is our limiting factor in this approach. The anterior tibial artery around 4.5 centimeters from the plateau or 3.5 centimeters from the fibular head. As you see that the popliteal vessels come, the popliteal spread into posterior tibial, anterior tibial, the anterior tibial goes above the interosseous ligament to go anterior. You don't want to injure this in this approach. And again, you should be careful with your homan in the posteromedial approach because you are putting your homan in this area. So if you are putting the homan, you need to put it high up towards the top of the head of the fibula, not low in the interosseous area where you can injure the vessel also. So be careful of your homan in this area. So this is the approach. It's going to be a direct posterolateral. We're doing roughly around 5 centimeters above and maybe 5 to 7 centimeters below the joint line. Guys, stop talking, stop working, stop touching anything till we finish, please. So, we do a direct incision. Again, we want to expose the lateral head of gastrocnemius. At the upper part of the approach, as you see, is the common peroneal nerve. So this is, again, one of the risks that we face in the beginning. It's immediately under the deep fascia. So when you are splitting the deep fascia above, be careful because you, the common peroneal will be your upper limiting part on the lateral side. Once you do that, we elevate the gastrocnemius and then we have the popliteus ending and we want to see the popliteus. We want to see the anterior tibial vessels coming under, over the popliteus and under the soleus. Okay, just as we see that view, we all must expose that, like the exposure on the right. And I'll show you now on the cadaver. And then this is if you cut the popliteus. So one option is to work around the popliteus. The other option is you may cut it, but obviously it's not preferable because it's an important muscle. You can be very extensile, cut the popliteus, and even release the soleus from the back of the fibula if you have to. But this is not the usual. Okay? So we will show you now the approach. I want you to realize how these approaches play out. So we've done the posteromedial, which almost ends at the knee joint. Like in this approach is centered slightly higher. So although it's a limited approach in what we can do in it, it's actually not a very small approach. And it, because it's got these risk factors associated with it. So we're just going to cut these sutures. So as we said, you're doing around 5 to 7 below and around 5 centimeters above. Once you do that, same as you've done in the posteromedial approach, you should do a nice dissection of the subcutaneous tissues. You'll find a thick, deep fascia in which you need to excise vertically all the way from the beginning of the wound above all the way down. Now, as I mentioned, the main thing in this part is the common peroneal nerve, which we meet immediately on the superolateral part of this approach. So that's why be careful when you're doing your deep fascia, take care, and you need to see the common peroneal nerve. Is it clear? Okay? Then, this is a common peroneal, Dr. Wael is showing us. So this is it. Okay? Now we want to feel, maybe if we do a little bit of flexion, then the lateral head of gastrocnemius will be able to dissect it easier. And similar to what we saw on the other side, but slightly different, is we need to look at the vessels. Sorry. You need to look at the vessels and see them. Once we lift the gastrocnemius, we will see the anterior tibial vessels coming under the soleus. So it's quite similar to the other side, but in a different manner. So these are the, this is the soleus. It's attached to the tibia and it's attached to the posterior fibula. So if you're feeling the head of the fibula, this is the soleal attachment. These are the vessels. Here you have the gastrocnemius, which is easier when you flex the knee, and this is the popliteus muscle. Okay? So the popliteus muscle is under the vessel, similar to what we did on the other side. You'll need to mobilize. There is the genicular vessel, which you might face here. You'll need to mobilize on the superior part of the popliteus and maybe open the capsule here to see the articular surface. Okay, so now Dr. Wael is lifting the lateral meniscus, and now we can, we are on the, is it clear on the video? Aywa. So, aywa, thank you. So, now this is the upper tibia, this is the meniscus that Dr. Wael is lifting, and the plate, you will have to mobilize the popliteus to put the plate around this part and just go under on the upper tibial surface, this area. So this is where our plate will be. We have a small plate here. So more, the more we flex. So I can see the vessel right here being retracted. So this is the vessel. I can put a very small plate here and put some screws here. However, sometimes you don't need to put the plate here. Actually, if you are doing a long, longer plate, like so. Actually, sometimes, as we mentioned, from the medial approach, you can reach a very large area of the lateral approach. You see now, I've mobilized, I've put my plate from the medial side. So now I've put my plate from the medial side. See how far I can reach on near the head of the fibula. So if you put the plate from the medial side, you can put screws there. But you cannot put screws here unless you do the posterior approach. So sometimes that's the only aim of this approach, is to put the screws in a plate coming from the other side. And it's safer now. I don't need to do a vertical plate, which might jeopardize the anterior tibial vessel. So you have to see these vessels again. You have the popliteal vessels and the anterior tibial branches coming out under the soleus. Okay? So again, I'll just show you again the approach. We go out of the layers again. So once you open the deep fascia, be careful to see the common peroneal nerve. You bend the knee a little bit to relax the gastrocnemius head. We will see the popliteal vessels and the anterior tibial branches coming under the soleus muscle. This is the soleus arch. We've seen them already them pass on the other side. Here they give us the anterior tibial vessels over the popliteus muscle, which is here. We mobilize it up or down to get access to the joint and get that access to the small part here. Okay? Hotel small image. Okay. Dr. Wayne wants to take a picture. Okay, the image will take time. So you start the approach, then we'll put the plate and give you a picture with the C arm.